Welcome to Headlines Simsbury, I'm Karen Handville. This year, when you adjust your clock back an hour, remember to change the battery in your smoke and carbon monoxide detectors. This year, Sunday, November 3rd ends daylight saving time. Use the extra hour to change the batteries and have peace of mind. Working alarms save lives. Simsbury residents are encouraged to give input by taking a survey for the town's Parks and Open Space Master Plan. The survey can be found on the Culture, Parks and Recreation website, simsburyrec.com, and the town's website, simsbury-ct.gov. A public hearing about the master plan is scheduled for October 29th at 7 p.m. at the Simsbury Library. The town of Simsbury has openings to serve on many of the town's boards and commissions. Ericka Butler has more.
Hello, Simsbury residents. My name is Ericka Butler, and I have the privilege of serving as your town clerk. Today, I'm here to talk to you a little bit about the volunteer process in regards to serving on an appointed board and/or commission here in town. If you are interested in serving your town, this is a great opportunity for you. First, start by identifying any boards and/or commissions that you may be interested in volunteering for. Maybe your current past career is related to the scope of the board or commission. Maybe you have served on a board or commission in the past that has helped you gain relevant knowledge to a certain board or commission here in town. Maybe you want to get involved with a board or commission whose mission is something you are passionate about. Whatever the reason may be, I am sure we have at least one board or commission that you will find interesting. A list of all of Simsbury's appointed boards and commissions can be found on the town's website. You may even want to take a look at current and past agendas and minutes to get a better feel of what topics are covered at the meetings. Next, once you have found a board or commission that interests you, check out the website meeting calendar to determine the days and times that the board or commission meets and make sure they match your availability. Remember, choosing a board or commission that interests you and is one whose schedule fits your schedule is very important in helping you remain an active participant. Finally, tell us a little bit about yourself by completing the volunteer form located on the town's website and submit. For more information on the process, please visit www.simsbury-ct.gov/volunteer. And as always, if you have any questions at all, I would be glad to talk with you. You can call or email me at 860-658-3243 or ebutler@simsbury-ct.gov. Thank you for your time, and I look forward to receiving your volunteer forms.
Leaf collection will run from November 18th through November 29th. Please note that all leaves must be in biodegradable paper bags. Plastic bags will not be accepted. You can find biodegradable bags at most hardware stores, grocery stores, and larger retailers. Check the leaf collection schedule for when it will occur in your neighborhood by going to the town's website, simsbury-ct.gov, and clicking on leaf collection schedule from the news section on the homepage. Dates are weather permitting. Residents can also bring bagged leaves to the landfill for free during normal hours on Wednesdays and Saturdays from 8 a.m. to 3 p.m. The annual Tarifville Halloween Parade and Party will be on Sunday, October 28th at 1 p.m. Participants of all ages are welcome to meet at the firehouse, then march to the village green. There will be snacks, music, a costume contest, and trick-or-treating. The event is sponsored by the Tarifville Village Association, the Tarifville School PTO, the Fire Company, Trinity Church, and Fitzgerald's. For more information, you can contact John Nagy at the email address on the screen. The festivities will be held at the Trinity Church Parish Hall if the weather is bad. On Saturday, November 2nd, from 6:30 to 9 p.m., the Farmington River Watershed Association will host the second annual Wild and Scenic Film Festival in the historic Town Hall Auditorium at 4 Market Street in Collinsville. 50 Years of Wild and Scenic Rivers is the curated collection of 7 documentaries that span the topics of wild and scenic rivers, fly fishing, biodiversity, pollinators, and more. The evening will include guest speakers, light refreshments, a raffle, and door prizes. Tickets are $20 in advance and $25 at the door and can be purchased at the Watershed's office, 749 Hot Meadow Street, or online at frwa.org. For more information, you can contact Laura Hart at 658-4442, extension 203, or email the address on the screen. The festival is an extension of the Watershed's work to inspire people to act on behalf of the Farmington River. On October 11th, National Coming Out Day, community members gathered to paint the newly designed installation of the Rainbow Crosswalk. If you missed it, here's a glimpse. Farmington Valley Symphony Orchestra will perform Scandinavian Masterworks on Saturday, November 2nd at 4:30 p.m. in the Millard Auditorium at the University of Hartford. Featuring music from Sibelius's Symphony No. 2 in D major and Grieg's Piano Concerto in A minor, featuring pianist Joshua Sawicki. For more information and tickets, go to fvso.org. Auditions for Simsbury Light Opera's performance of Gilbert and Sullivan's The Pirates of Penzance will be held Sunday, November 3rd from 6 to 8 p.m. and Tuesday, November 5th from 7 to 9 p.m. at Basingstoke on 5 Herman Drive. You can email sloco at sloco.org for more information. St. Catherine of Siena Women's Club Ministry is having its holiday craft fair on Saturday, November 2nd from 9 a.m. until 3 p.m. in Russell Hall to 65 Stratton Brook Road. They will also offer a bake sale and cafe. For more information or questions, you can contact Janet Fisher at 989-6045 or email the address on the screen. Nick, Ethan, and Sutton are here to tell you about the Theater Guild's upcoming production of A Christmas Carol.
Hello, my name is Nick Parisi, and for 5 performances this November, I'll be playing Ebenezer Scrooge, the despised miser of Charles Dickens' famous tale, A Christmas Carol, reimagined as a heartwarming musical, with music by Alan Menken, whose credits include Disney's Beauty and the Beast and The Little Mermaid, and lyrics from Lynn Arends of ragtime and Seussical fame. This joyous show will please all ages as it celebrates the spirit of the coming holidays. I play the elderly version of Scrooge, but let me introduce my younger selves who can shed light on my transformation into a bitter old miser. Ethan Quinn plays Scrooge as a young boy.
I learned my first lesson as my father was being dragged off to debtor's prison when he said to me, "Save your pennies, make your fortune, and keep it. Save your pennies."
Sutton Kaylor portrays Scrooge as a young man just starting out in business.
I was so focused on making and saving my pennies that I lost Emily, the love of my life. As she left, she said to me, "You love nothing quite so much as gold."
You'll also meet 4 ghosts, 3 of whom lead me through my past, present, and future, forcing me to recognize my faults. Happily, I repent my selfish ways, greeting Christmas morning with a cheerful, happy Christmas, rather than my usual, bah, humbug. A Christmas Carol will be presented by the Theater Guild of Simsbury at the Simsbury High School on November 16th, 22nd, and 23rd at 7:30 p.m. Sunday matinee performances will be November 17th and 24th at 2 p.m. You may purchase tickets online at www.theaterguildsimsbury.org. See you there, enjoy the show, and God bless us, everyone.
The not-for-profit Farmington Valley Trails Council will hold its annual meeting on Friday, November 15th at 6:30 p.m. at the Avon Senior Center, 635 West Avon Road, the Sycamore Recreation Park in Avon. Admission is free and refreshments will be served. The guest speaker this year is Marge Nichols, who will present her slideshow, Bicycling Across Cambodia. Marge and two friends bicycled 200 miles across central Cambodia and explored many ancient temple ruins, paddled through a floating village on a giant lake, biked country roads, and visited a crocodile farm. Visit fchtrail.org for more information. The Simsbury Celebrates Committee invites the public to participate in the 10th annual gingerbread competition and exhibit, one of the most beloved attractions at Simsbury Celebrates. Registration is open until Friday, November 15th, and registration forms and guidelines are available at simsburycelebrates.com or simsburyrec.com. Entry categories include masters, adults, youth, mixed groups, and non-competitive display only. First, second, and third place winners in each competitive category will be awarded on Sunday, November 24th. The first 35 entrants are guaranteed a spot in the exhibit to be viewed by thousands at Simsbury Celebrates on Saturday, November 30th from 5 to 7 p.m. The gingerbread exhibit at the Simsbury Free Library will also be open to the public from 11 to 5 on November 26th, December 3rd, and December 5th. A gingerbread house workshop for adults only will also be offered on Thursday, October 24th from 7 to 9 p.m. at Freemasons Hall for a $25 registration fee, and you can register at simsburyrec.com. Stephanie Prato is here with What's Going On at the Library.
Hi, my name is Stephanie Prato, and I'm the head of Children's Services at the Simsbury Public Library. We have some fun opportunities for families coming up, including our annual holiday photo shoot. On November 9th from 10:30 until 4:30, the Simsbury Camera Club will be taking family portraits at the Simsbury Public Library. You can use these photos for your holiday cards or a family portrait. The fee for a 20-minute session is $50, cash or check, which includes all of your digital photos. To schedule your session or for more information, please contact the library at phone number 860-658-7663, option 4. We're also planning for Simsbury Celebrates, which is an event for all ages the Saturday after Thanksgiving. The library will be open extended hours for this special event on Saturday, November 30th, and will close at 7:30 p.m. instead of our normal 5:30. We're featuring holiday music with Marie Lim in the children's room, a puppet show in the program room, and more. The fire truck parade will take place on Hot Meadow Street at 7:30 p.m., and the fireworks are currently scheduled for 8:30. For more information about this free event and how you can support it, please visit simsburycelebrates.com. For young children who are not yet in school, we're continuing our Storytown series with visits to the Pumpkin Patch, Anna's Kitchen, and the Simsbury Police Department. On Tuesday, October 29th at 10:30 a.m., you can meet us at the Pumpkin Patch by First Church, address 89 Hot Meadow Street. Fingers crossed for good weather because this outdoor program will be canceled in rain. On Tuesday, November 12th at 10:30 a.m., meet us at Anna's Kitchen to read cozy stories by the fireplace. Finally, on Tuesday, November 19th at 10:30, meet us at the police department to read stories and take pictures. We haven't forgotten about Halloween fun, and we'll be celebrating with a Halloween story time full of songs, fun, and books that go boo. Little ones are encouraged to come in costume on Wednesday, October 30th at 10:30 a.m. for this event. We've also planned some great events for school-age children as well. Children in third through fifth grade can sign up for fun math-themed programs, including Bouncy Dice Explosion, Spy Training, and Daring Darts. These awesome hands-on math programs take place every other Thursday at 4 p.m. and are made possible by the Crazy Eights Club from the Bedtime Math Foundation. Call or go online to sign up. As we're coming to the end of October, we're celebrating Halloween and Day of the Dead. Kids in grades kindergarten through sixth can join us for a pumpkin craft and decorating a trick-or-treat bag to use on Halloween night on Tuesday, October 29th at 4 p.m. Then on Saturday, November 2nd at 10 a.m., drop in to watch the Oscar-winning movie Coco and do a craft celebrating Day of the Dead. Finally, as we head into November, we'll highlight Election Day with a voting activity for kids and an Election Day craft. Kids can color their own flag on a Simsbury Public Schools No School Day, Tuesday, November 5th at 2 p.m. Thank you for listening. I hope you're as excited as I am about fall programs, and we'll see you at the library soon.
The Simsbury Camera Club will be taking family portraits at the Simsbury Library on Saturday, November 9th from 10 a.m. to 4:30 p.m. Use the portraits as gifts or on your holiday cards. The 20-minute session is $50 by cash or check and includes digital photos. To schedule your session or get more information, contact the library at 658-7663 and use option 4. Mary Doyle-Clark is here with what's going on at the Senior Center.
Hi, I'm Mary Doyle-Clark, and here's what's going on at the Simsbury Senior Center. Veterans, their friends, and family members are invited to the Senior Center for our next Veterans Coffee on Monday, November 4th at 10 a.m. Travis Schweitzer, U.S. Navy Captain, retired, and President of the U.S. Veterans Chamber of Commerce, will be our guest speaker. This event is co-sponsored by Simsbury Senior Center and Resilience Grows Here, a community-based initiative of the Farmington Valley Health District. The Senior Center will offer two new fitness classes beginning in November. CardioFit will be held on Tuesdays and Thursdays from 9 to 9:45 a.m. This class is a safe and heart-healthy aerobics class to energize your active lifestyle using low-impact movements that focus specifically on building upper body and core strength plus cardio endurance. Chair Fitness will be on Thursdays from 1:30 to 2:15 p.m. and is designed to increase muscle strength range of movement and improve activities for daily living. A chair is used for seated exercises and standing support, and class can be modified depending on fitness levels. Both of these classes will be free with Silver Sneakers or Renew Active by United Healthcare. For more information, call the Senior Center. Learn about Simsbury Public Library's virtual reality headset and take part in a virtual experience from 1 to 2 p.m. on Thursday, November 7th at Simsbury Public Library. Virtual reality is the use of computer technology to create a simulated environment. Instead of viewing a screen, users are immersed and able to interact with 3D worlds by simulating as many senses as possible, such as vision, hearing, and touch. This free event is co-sponsored by the Senior Center and Public Library. You may register at either location. The St. Mary's Church Parish Hall will become Party Central for a seasonal favorite from noon to 2 p.m. on Wednesday, November 20th, with their annual Thanksgiving luncheon for local seniors. Festivities begin at noon with a meal that features traditional Thanksgiving fare, as well as beverages and dessert served by students, faculty, and volunteers from St. Mary's School. This free event will take place at the Parish Center, which is located at 942 Hot Meadow Street in Simsbury. Reservations are necessary and can be made through the Senior Center. The Simsbury Senior Center is located at 754 Hot Meadow Street in the Eno Memorial Hall building. Our hours are Mondays, 8:30 a.m. to 7 p.m., Tuesday through Thursday, 8:30 a.m. to 4:30 p.m., and Fridays, 8:30 a.m. to 1 p.m. Call us at 860-658-3273 for additional information or go to our website. Thanks for watching. See you at the Senior Center.
Relive the magic of one of the greatest movie heroes, Indiana Jones, in Raiders of the Lost Ark on the 40-foot silver screen with the John Williams epic score performed live to the film by the Hartford Symphony Orchestra on Saturday, November 2nd at 7:30 p.m. in the Bushnell. Visit hartfordsymphony.org for tickets and more information. Marianne Bannan is here with information about this year's Turkey Trot.
My name is Marianne Bannan, and you guessed it, the Turkey Trot is just around the corner. This year marks the 27th annual Jack Bannan Memorial Turkey Trot to benefit FoodShare. The one-day event will be on Wednesday, November 20th, from 8 a.m. to 8 p.m. We hope to reach a goal of collecting 2,700 turkeys and $27,000 in monetary donations as a follow-up to the tremendous outpouring of support last year. For early risers, we will accept contributions beginning at 4:30 a.m. at Simsbury Stop and Shop, where you can personally present your donations to Scott Haney of WFSB-TV. He will be broadcasting live there until 7 a.m. This event was started by my dad, Jack Bannan, in 1993 to benefit FoodShare and demonstrates the incredible difference that one person can make. What a wonderful legacy I've inherited of giving back to the community and helping others in need. From our humble beginnings, collecting 269 turkeys that first year, my dad's dedication gradually paid off. He was highly motivated to prevent hunger from his personal experience as a starving prisoner of war in Germany during World War II. He also had a tremendous supporter at FoodShare, the former executive director, Gloria McAdam. Gloria became a great friend of my father's and mine. Sadly, Gloria lost her battle with brain cancer earlier this year. We wish to dedicate the Turkey Trot this year to Gloria's memory. Without her encouragement and support, the Turkey Trot may not have grown into the tremendous event it's become, encompassing stores and schools in Avon, Canton, Granby, Bloomfield, and Simsbury. Our efforts continue today because the need still exists. Today, the Turkey Trot is the largest single-day collection event for FoodShare, and we know it makes a major difference for families, not only on Thanksgiving, but throughout the year. I hope you will consider making a donation to the Turkey Trot in memory of Gloria McAdam or someone who has made a difference in your life. We will be collecting turkeys, non-perishable items, cash or checks made payable to FoodShare on Wednesday, November 20th. Please come out and see us at Fitzgerald's, Kane's or Stop and Shop in Simsbury, Miller Foods or Big Y in Avon, Geisler's or Stop and Shop in Granby, ShopRite of Canton, or Bloomfield Geisler's. Donations can be dropped off at our tractor trailers behind Henry James Memorial School in Simsbury throughout the day. On behalf of my family and our volunteers, thank you for your generosity and ongoing support as we carry on my dad's and Gloria's legacies. I extend my personal thanks to my dedicated committee members who give so generously of their time and energy. This event would simply not be possible without you. Most importantly, I want to express my gratitude to the huge number of volunteers that come out the day of this event, including members of our fire and police departments. My unending appreciation to our corporate donors for providing services to our event, including Wilmarth & Associates, Liberty Bank, Bizzuto's, Syracusa Moving and Storage, Harvest Cafe, Signs Plus, Suburban Sanitation, Vincent Funeral Home, Gifts of Love, and Avon Self Storage. A heartfelt thank you to our participating grocery stores who provide access to their premises, create special incentives, and give customers an opportunity to conveniently join in this worthy effort. Please support these businesses who add so much to our quality of life in our community. For more information or to volunteer, please call me at 860-668-5352 or Harold and Erickson at 860 965-0301. The true essence of community is defined by neighbors helping neighbors. Please join us in this effort on Wednesday, November 20th. Best wishes for a wonderful holiday season with your family and friends. Thank you.
The Simsbury Historical Society has new items in their gift shop, which is open from Thursday to Saturday, noon to 4 p.m. Check out their website, simsburyhistory.org. Here's Dara with this week's The Simon Foundation Pet Spotlight.
Hi, it's Dara again with the Pet Spotlight for the Simon Foundation in Bloomfield, Connecticut. Did you know the Simon Foundation ensures you meet your pet under the best conditions? Kennels are loud. That's why after you fill out an adoption application, we make an appointment and you get to meet your pet one-on-one with no distractions. The pet's real temperament shines through and you can bond. I've got two great pets to show you.
But first, some happy news. Roxy, May, and our tiny striped kitten have all been adopted. Happy forever, sweet babies.
This handsome boy is Samson. He's a two-year-old mixed breed. Samson came to us with a collar so embedded that he needed surgery to remove it. Despite the neglect he suffered as a puppy, he's grown into a loving, happy dog. Samson adores people and attention. His upbeat demeanor includes the ability to jump. He'd do best in a home with experienced owners, a fence, and no other pets. He knows his basic commands and loves extra TLC. This lovely girl is Bonnie. Bonnie's a 2.5-year-old pit bull terrier. She's high energy and loves her zoomies. Bonnie's fine with kids and cats. She prefers the company of female dogs. If she's uncomfortable with the situation, she has a great way of dealing with it. She calmly sits and turns her back. What a good girl. Bonnie's a major snuggle bug, so get ready to share the sofa.
If you're interested in these pets or any of their friends at the Simon Foundation, go to thesimonfoundation.org and fill out an application to adopt. Thanks a lot.
We hope you enjoyed this program and we invite your feedback. Contact SCTV at 658-1720 or email me at karen@simsburytv.org. If you're interested in volunteering here or just have questions or you're just curious, we invite you to visit us in the lower level of Eno Memorial Hall. If you have something to say or share, Simsbury residents can produce non-commercial programming in our studio for free. If you need to catch up on a town meeting or missed the latest inside Trojan football, visit our website, simsburytv.org, to watch programs on demand. Or subscribe to our YouTube channel. I'm Karen Handville, and we are SCTV, your town, your schools, your government.
Funding for Simsbury Community Television is provided in part by contributions from viewers like you. Thank you.